Hi, I'm Benny Knott from Noisy Post, and I work in audio post-production. So I do sound design, dialogue editing, mixing for feature films, television commercials, as well as live shows. For those who are new to the channel, I also educate in these areas on this YouTube channel, and I'm also building some courses. And I have some great partners who help me in this. That includes GODOX, Blackmagic Design, and also Kiloview, who make the M40, which is a unit for converting video into NDI. Now, previously I made a video on how to use these units and how I record them to make long form content. But also I live stream as I work on my productions. I'm gonna show you now how I use these M40 units by Kiloview and OBS to live stream to you guys here on YouTube. In a previous video, I talked about how you can set up the Kiloview N40s. And you can see it up here or down in the description below. And that's talking more about how I record all my long form and reviews of gear as well. And this is the recorder software that they have. So this recorder software, you can have as many inputs as you really want, or there's like, you know, more than you could handle cameras wise. But you can see here, I've got both the cameras units coming in, and I've got my screen capture happening as well as audio. So that's mic only. And that microphone is set by NDI. So NDI Toolkit, which you can download for free, has a bunch of software, but it's got screen capture. And what it does is it just adds this tab down here. You can choose your frame rate and audio sources. So you can record your sound from your computer, but I've got my microphone set up here. So that's capturing my shotgun going through an audio unit. I'm recording this at the moment for the sake of making this video, but also what I'm recording it for is to show you OBS. But before I do that, I just want to show you, I've got here, this is what happens when you log into the NDI units themselves, the N40s. It tells you all the stats. You can change things like the bitrate, which I've got it lowered because I'm only on a gigabit network, and with the two cameras and the top one being 4K, I want that at a lower level, just so I'm not overloading my network. But you can see the camera here. So I've got this one at only HD because it only needs to be HD. The other one's at 4K because I want to be able to punch in on the mixers and controllers, particularly when I'm recording courses and stuff like that. And I want to do a lot more editing and polishing of those courses rather than a lot of the YouTube stuff. So then last thing I want to show you is OBS here. So as you can see, that's my screen that you're looking at here of OBS. And I've actually only doing 2/3 of the screen. I used to have a wide screen, which was perfect for doing this. So I'd get a nice wide screen shot and then you'd have this at the bottom. But that screen got damaged during the transition from old studio to this studio. And so now what I do is just have Pro Tools or DaVinci Resolve Fairlight in that top third. And I have these down the bottom. So you can see my mixer and what I'm doing, as well as this is my projector screen. So what's up on the screen there, you'll see it here. So whatever's being played in the production, and obviously you see my pretty face again, but I've got multiple setups here. So we start with a blank one. I go into my intro video that's got some music and things so people can make sure the audio is working and all that sort of stuff. We got full cam so I can talk to you. We've got the split screen. I've got a mixer cam, which is more about the mixer, but you can still see my screen smaller here, projector screen and my face down there. I've got to be right back if I have to take a quick call or whatever. And then I've got my outro, which plays an overlapping thing. So what I'll do is I'll go, hey, see you later. Thanks for watching, blah, blah, blah. And then go, bye. And that does that. You just go add NDI source here. And then you want to you add a new source, we'll call it nothing. And you can see here's all my NDI sources. So there's the audio, there's the screens, and then there's my cameras. And what you can also do is allow a hardware accelerator. So if you have I've got NVIDIA GPU, that will help that run better through the GPU. I would have thought with the Macs these days, I think they have like the H.265 or 4 codec stuff built in to it. So that is worth checking and seeing anyway. So there it is, there's the camera, NDI right there, all good, ready to go. Honestly, it's so easy with NDI. Now I'm clearly recording on my setup. I'm also streaming. The recording's obviously at a higher quality than what would be streaming. So if you want to, you can record within OBS. So you can record a video of OBS, like your screens and all that sort of stuff, and make a production out of that. but you're also recording the ISO files, which are on my screen over here. You're recording the isolated files as well. So if you want to make a higher quality production post, you know, and re-edit it, you can do that as well. One thing that I'm hoping gets fixed soon is that the files that are made through NDI, any NDI recorder, can't be used in DaVinci or in like Premiere and stuff like that. So I'm using just Handbrake free software, and I've got to transcode everything before I can edit it in my NLE. But it's not a great system because that's extra time that you have to take to convert things before you can edit them. But unfortunately, that's just the way it is at the moment. I'm going to be handing Blackmagic to get them to fix that. But because they also make things like ATEM switches and other streaming and also editing stuff, they may never give NDI a look, but that's something I'm going to look into as well. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about the N40 units themselves or my OBS setup, feel free to write any questions in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can, and I'll see you on the next one.